Here with our weekly update with head coach TJ Otzelberger. Let's recap last week. Early last week, head down to Ole Miss. Great start by your team. A lot of three-pointers made. They came back to tie it and got the lead, actually, but forced overtime. And then you prevailed in overtime. A good win for your program.
Yeah, I thought our guys did a tremendous job of coming out with great aggressiveness. Got out to a 12-0 run on their court. I think we had a very focused, loose mentality in terms of just, you know, playing with confidence and knocked down some shots early, really built our confidence, and we're able to get out to a big lead in that first half because we kind of stuck with that plan, and we're up 55-35 at the break and built a nice lead.
Hope to carry that momentum over to Saturday against Missouri State. They got off to a quick start there. They were hot from three and you just couldn't quite get things going. What was kind of the story of the game on Saturday down in the Pentagon?
Yeah, unfortunately, I think Missouri State was certainly the more aggressive team on Saturday. And then, you know, part of playing this game is making shots early. And we struggled offensively early. They got some shots to fall. Alize Johnson, their best player, who had hit two threes all season long, hit two early against us. That built their confidence. And, you know, they hit nine first half threes, and part of the game is aggressiveness and physicality, and part of it is the ball going in the hole. And I think they took advantage of us in all those facets of the game and making shots. They were the more aggressive team, physical team on the boards, and that's why we weren't really able to get things going.
Is that game a concern for you with how physical they were, or is that just kind of one where they were so hot early and they just kind of rode their momentum?
I think a lot of things play into it. You know, we've been on the road a bunch, you know, so you've been traveling a lot. And even though that game was in Sioux Falls, you're still away from home. So we've had a lot of travel. I think that plays into it. We've played very well. And I think that sometimes every night, you know, you'd love to have your best game every single night out. That wasn't our best. They're a team that's really good. And they jumped on us early. And I think a lot of things played in. I don't think it's concerning in the long run. In the short run, certainly disappointing because we want to win every game and give our best effort and play our best every night, and we didn't do that. In the long run, it needs to be something that we learn from. It needs to be one of those games you chalk up to experience, and we don't let it happen again.
Well, this tough stretch continues this week. You got Wichita State tomorrow, number 8 in the country right now. They're just going to be a tough team to play tomorrow night.
Yeah, they're as good as any team in the country, and we've played Kansas, who I believe is ranked number 2, and Wichita is right there. They're every bit as good. So they're a tremendous rebounding team, unbelievable physical team on the boards. They out-rebound their opponents by 16. Their margin of victory is tremendous. Their assist-to-turnover ratio, and they shoot more free throws than their opponents, or they make more than their opponents' attempts. So they're really strong in a lot of areas. We're going to have to do a great job taking care of the basketball. We're going to have to give our best effort every time a shot goes up to compete on the glass with an unrelenting spirit, because they are really good. And then we're going to have to knock down shots. I mean, if you're going to win a game on the road against a really good team, especially with the size and physicality of Wichita, that's part of the game too. And that's why we're able to be successful at Ole Miss. And that's why we're successful against another bigger team with Iowa. And we're going to have to make some shots early, get our confidence going as well.
Does anything come out of the game from last year? Obviously, you weren't playing that well last year when you played there, but a lot of the guys on the team now played there last year. Is there anything that can be taken from that and applied to this year, having played in that environment?
You know, I think there's absolutely the truth of having been there. We know the environment. It's a really tough one to play in. I mean, similar to playing at Fog Allen Fieldhouse, you've got a very passionate fan base that comes out and supports in big numbers, and they're on you from start to finish. Certainly can't expect to get any calls. It's going to be a physical game, and that's how it is on the road. So, we've got to continue to battle and compete every possession. We've got to have a mindset that we can go in there and win, and that's how we're preparing for the game. And, we have tremendous respect for their program. We know that they're really good. But we've got confidence in our group, and we've got to do what we do, and we've got to execute, and we've got to do that well and put ourselves in position. And having gone there last year, we know what to expect.
And then on Friday, you'll return home. It seems like it's been a while, but you'll have Concordia, Nebraska in. They're 8-2, but it'll be a good time for your team to get back home.
Yeah, it's important for us to get back to Frost Arena. We want to play in front of our fans. We feed off their energy. Certainly exciting. And be back, sleep in our beds and on our home court, and especially in a time where final exams are going on, we need to make sure that you know, we take care of our business in the classroom as well. So right on time for us to be able to come back home, play a team that's, they're playing well. Concordia's doing a great job and off to a great start. And so we're going to have to bring it. But also for us to be back in front of our fans and playing in Frost Arena, it's huge, because we derive so much energy and enthusiasm from the fans. And to have it be part of a doubleheader with wrestling makes it extra special.